All right, yes, we are talking to Jukka Halme, who is one of the co-chairs of the Helsinki convention that's coming up next year. Now, what's the official title for this one is Mid-American 2. What's Helsinki going to be called?
We are calling our convention the 75th Worldcon, the Worldcon 75. Simply, we wanted to brand the name. We wanted to use the Worldcon because it doesn't really. We could have chosen some silly name like Hellcon or whatever and go with that, but it wouldn't have told, especially the Finns and the other Nordic countries and possibly even the rest of the Europe that much. The Worldcon in itself means something, and we wanted to use that. And since it's the 75th one, 75, it's a strong number, good number.
Now, the bid process for Kansas City took 4 or 5 years. How long did you guys get started before the actual decision to go to Helsinki?
We started 2012. We started in Shikon 7, and we actually aimed for 2015. So we had a very short 1 year period of bidding, and we lost in San Antonio on a third round with 35 votes. Heartbreaking, crushing defeat. But then again, we're used to being second, so that's very Finnish thing to do, the Finnish second. Yeah. But then we had a small break, couple of months, and then we thought, well let's not go about wasting our momentum, but keep going on. I mean, for 1 year bid to get that kind of a result was really good. I was completely, honestly expecting us to win, really, but to make our presence known, get people know that there is a science fiction, thriving science fiction fantasy culture fandom in Finland, and to get the word out. And since the word out was so well received, we thought, okay, let's go forward. And last year in Spokane at Sasquan, we beat everybody in the first round already. So the word is out, and I think people are really interested in what kind of a welcome we are going to have next year.
Now, as I understand it, tradition is that the next year's host city throws the party after the Hugos this year. So if I've got that right, you guys are going to be doing the party after the Hugos. So what kind of a blowout do you have planned?
We are going to do the traditional Hugo losers party, which was invented here in Kansas City 40 years ago by George R. R. Martin and Gardner Dozois. And it's a tradition. It used to be the tradition that the losers, the actual losers, would get together and waste themselves and do some damage. It has become a lot more sophisticated affair, unfortunately, far too sophisticated. So we would have loved to bring a bit of a Finnish rowdiness to it. But apparently Kansas City is a bit of a moderate city, and we can't really do that much thing. But there's going to be some shindig happening tomorrow night at the undisclosed location.
Now, is Martin going to pass out the Alfies at this particular shindig that you're hosting, or is that going to be something else?
It's going to be after that, yes. We're sort of a warm-up party for the Martin party. For the Martin party, yes.
Martin party of 7. Okay, so after the Martin party with the Alfies, then the big Finnish blowout after that, right?
I think we'll be blown out already by then. It's, we're not going to wait too long to do some things that we cannot do, or possibly cannot do on Sunday, since on Monday I'll have to leave and go back home. And it's a long, arduous journey, and you can't do that with too much heavy in the head.
So how many Worldcons have you personally attended?
I have attended eight. Yeah, if we count this one.
And I expect the experience is different every single time. What's your takeaway from this one? You're going to go back home, and you're going to tell what kind of stories about Kansas City?
Oh, I'm going to tell that Kansas City apparently is the barbecue capital of the world, although I haven't eaten any barbecue yet. haven't had.
We gotta get on that.
I haven't had time for that. I'm really disappointed for my efforts so far, but I haven't really seen programming. I have my minions to do that for me, especially the Swedes. They love to go to programming and see what's happening. But I've been stuck behind our table and talking to people, which is the best part, really. Sure. To meet new people and have nice discussions and chats. I'm going to go back home, hopefully with a lot of intel, both from myself and all the rest of the people who are here, who are part of our team, whether they are Finns, Swedes, Europeans, other Europeans, Americans, or whatnot. And see, because the locations where Worldcon takes place are pretty much a large convention center. And this one has similarities with the convention center in Helsinki that we're using.
So what kind of takeaways, as far as the way this show has come together, the way it's run, you talk about taking a bunch of intel back. Is this going to be more along the lines of seeing things that you want to do differently or seeing things that you want to duplicate or a little bit of both?
I think it's a little bit of both. The idea for us is to bring the world to Worldcon. This used to be like the World Series with your national pastime, where you win the world, where only you and occasional Canadian team play.
Right.
So and Worldcon as a Anglo-American science fiction fantasy convention is very much an English-speaking affair, and we're not going to change that. It's an English-speaking convention back home in Helsinki. But we want to bring a lot more into it. The way we were brought up back home was that most of us read it translated works that we're translating to Finnish. They're not necessarily only English-speaking language, science fiction and fantasy. There were Russian, there was Polish, Japanese, Swedish, Danish, French, Italian, everything. So there is a more of a world in our Finnish culture already. And we want to bring especially the European, especially the Finns, the Nordics, the people who are close to us, the Russians even, and then the rest of the Europe, and then hopefully Africa, South America, Asia, and I think English-speaking people from U.S. and U.K. Yeah, why not?
Why not? Yeah. All right. Well, Jukka Halme, the co-chair of Helsinki 2017.